Hello and welcome to SoftTech Forum. Today I'll be discussing on a few interview questions regarding SSIS. So first interview questions, it is very commonly used, what is ETL? So ETL is nothing but that extraction, transformation and load. E for extraction, T for transformation and L for load. So what is that ETL, like transformation, extraction and load? So and if you are going to any SSDT, SQL Server Data Tool, earlier it was calling us BITS, Business Intelligence Data Tool, so that Data Studio. So like in extension, if you are taking any data flow task, and there if you are just pulling any kind of source, Excel source or OLE DB source or whatever source it is, so this source is kind of extraction. It is extracting the data from other sources, and then transformation. Now let's say you want to do some transformation, the data conversion, derived columns you want to do. So that kind of things, it will be coming as a transformation. All that coming under transformation. Let's say derived column, if you are deriving that some column with some different format, no format or value. Let's say get that, if you are having, you are getting the age, right? Birthday if you are having, and you are trying to get the age over there, so you are driving that derived columns, and you want to load the data into the database tables. That is called load. So extraction, transformation and load, this all together called as ETL, to load the data from other source to different sources. This is called ETL. That's it. So you can go through this explanation in detail in my description. And next question, it will be, what are all the next new features are available in SQL Server 2012 from SQL Server 2008 R2. So SQL Server 2012, they have introduced a feature called undo. Undo option, like as I can see, I can do the control Z. I can press control Z, and if I'm pressing, it will be going off. Again, control Z, it will go off. Like that way, you can do the undo option available in 2012. Now let's say next is grouping task. Grouping task is also available in 2012. Let's say in here, you can see in that grouping, right? Here you can just group it. Here you can just bucket the number of few tasks into bucketing that task. You can group that task into that. Grouping options is available in 2012. Now let's that scope of the variables. If you want to change the scope of the variables, you can do that in the 2012. So let's go to that variables, and there you just go there and move variable, click on the move variable, and there you are just clicking that data flow task. As you can see, the scope of the variable is the package level. Now press on OK. You can see that scope of the variable is went, and where it went is like it is in the scope of the variable is moved to some other in that data flow task, you know. Let's say here, so scope of the variable, you can change it. Next feature is that decimal data type variable. The decimal data type was not there in 2008 R2. So now it is there. So expression character limit. In the expression character limit, we often have to write that expression, like 4000 character limit was there in 2008 R2. Whereas in 2012, there is no limitation in the expression. Like what you can get n number of lines within 2012 in expression. Zoom in and zoom out. You can see this is not a very widely used features as though, but you can do that zoom in and zoom out, which was not available in 2008 R2. And next features, it will be parameters and all. This parameters block has been introduced in 2012. Like here, you can just go through that UAT or production or QA with the help of parameter. Just change the parameter, it will work. And next features, it has been introduced as like new added features, like new added functions, left, token count and replace null. These are all new features, new functions has been introduced in 2012. Now row count GUI is this, where we are seeing that row count, right? Here you used to see all the variable used to come. Now in that rate, only the integer value variables, it will be coming, which is row count. So it will be simplified, like we are doing the transformation, it will be very useful for user friendly while choosing the row count variable. Data viewers also simplified, and then next thing is like ODBC source and ODBC destination has been introduced, CDC source, destination and splitter has been introduced. So thank you for watching this video. I'll be describing few new features, new questions and answer in my next video. Thank you. See you in the next video.